think we've got any more. Can you share them between yourselves? Awesome.
Have a good night.
Thanks.
Have a good night.
And to you.
You know, I never know people still do trick-or-treating here in London. I thought that's just America. I thought London was boring. People really do let their children go do trick-or-treating. Hey! That's the first time in a long time.
Now they've returned from their grave. Amy, I'm serious. It's not a joke.
I'm far enough.
I know this sounds dumb, but they're here tonight.
Come on, speak with them.
They're right over there.
Do you want any, before we start, do you want any extra categories? So like lover advice or financial advice?
Let's put love into it.
Okay, ooh. Let's put love to it. So can you pick me a pass please, a card? Okay, exactly like that.
Why are you thinking of that when you say
okay,
love?
Present. Future. And then we'll add the love room and I'll put that one here. Can I have my book, please? Thanks. Past, present, future, lover. Was that the right order?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I was looking. So I'm going to read. Should I read the same way that I read you towards me?
What did I say? Page of what?
Page of what?
Pentacles.
That's my pass, L.
Your what?
That's my pass.
Your what?
My past.
Oh, your past.
My past. My past. My past. I said my past.
A page of pentacles.
Please, if this is going on YouTube, please don't cancel me. Because I might be doing this wrong. But
well, are you going to put this on
I'm
YouTube?
Learning.
Don't worry. Ain't nobody gonna cancel you. Ain't no tarot card readers here. Ain't no tarot card readers watching this, so don't worry, ain't nobody getting cancelled.
This page reveals progress and adventure, as well as prosperous beginnings. This is a time to nurture your skills and abilities. Okay, so basically in the past you've had great beginnings. You've been able to nurture your skills and abilities. And you've possibly had good news, whether that be in, say, a financial way, receiving any form of way.
Oh, hell, whatever. I was very rich my past life.
Okay.
Temperance.
Doesn't look good. Is it the word temper? Just triggers.
No, it seems a very calm look. Card, it seems like it's talking about it, so keeping your temper, being
I've got anger management.
Yeah.
Oh, that means got anger management then.
No, we like
wait to see what it says.
I feel it's going to jump in like.
Okay, so it does relate to temper.
See, anger management. Here I come.
So it says that at the moment, so like as you can see on the card, it's like weighing up your options, like between the chalices. So it's. Temperance shows you're dealing with a potential volatile situation and you need to temper your thoughts and actions to find balance and harmony. So it's saying at the moment it's kind of an imbalance or uncertainty. So possibly with essays or with something, say at university, at your personal life, that there's something that internally could be an imbalance and an unsuring. And it says that you may be given a sign or advice from a friend or stranger possibly in the near future. This is kind of like for more of a future, but as a good idea. So like you may have been given a sign, you may have seen it, may have not seen it, but it's just at the moment currently you need to, like, you're weighing up your options.
What options?
And kind of looking, and that you're in a situation that may not be calming for yourself, if that makes sense.
So, there's an imbalance in my life. So that means I need to go to therapy, the psychiatric ward, anger management. And go to all them places. Does anyone know the number? Anybody? Production? Anybody? Does anyone have the number for anger management or to the therapy? Anybody? Or what's it called? Rehab. Anyone got the number? Demi Lovato? Anybody? Anybody? Anybody at all?
Let's see your future. Ace of Swords. Oh, this is interesting. So the Ace of Swords predicts new beginnings, decisions, and clear thinking, and usually relates to work and love. It heralds action, drama, and sometimes confrontation.
Oh, lovely.
The Ace of Swords manifests in your life. It will bring immediate change to your circumstances for better.
Drama.
There you go. So basically saying that in the future, you're going to find a confrontation and you're going to hit it and you're going to hit it hard.
As I always do.
Come through as best as you can. So whether, again, applying that to essays or work or working, say, in a group, possibly, if you don't find that, you know, you're suited for it, you're going to hit it hard and find an outcome that works best for you, whether that be, I don't know. You will discover that yourself, but it's about finding a new beginning and finding clear thinking. The one I'm most excited about, though,
the hermit.
But in reverse.
Okay. Oh, that doesn't sound right. Well, that means before I leave uni, I had to come to an argument with one of you.
Daniel, that someone who lives in someone else's house.
Okay, this is, I can see this, this is cool. Okay, so, when reversed, you may be feeling alone and unsupported. However, this is more of an attitude than reality.
It's reality.
So it's worth asking yourself if you are avoiding help. The card can also accept a role, perhaps victim or martyr, that you find hard to let go or due to habit or stubbornness.
What is book reading me?
The card can show a time where you cut off yourself from usual support systems or have been unfriended by those you trust. If this charms for you, go with the upright meaning and withdraw for a while. Rely on your own guidance. So basically, for your love life, it's saying that you're pulling yourself away and you're feeling a bit unsupported. But maybe there's those that are around you.
It's like your attitude is unattractive.
Yeah.
Thing.
So it's like, kind of sending your message into the ether.
That
it's
you're
like
not
you,
interested.
Yeah, like you put out what you want. I always find like if you think it, it will manifest itself because
I'm gonna be like, is there anyone?
If you truly want it,
don't just laugh. I'm asking you a question.
If you truly want it, it's there, but it's saying that if you feel you may feel unsupported.
Why did I pick that card?
But there's unsupport.
This is coming.
It's basically saying that you may feel unsupported, but there are those around you that support you
in your decisions.
I think that was a really good little reading.
Now, can you answer me?
What was the question?
Is there someone in the horizon?
Oh,
is
God,
there
no.
someone on your horizon? Mm-mm. At Brendan's YouTube channel?
Am I avoiding love? Well, I've never been in love, so I don't know how love feels. I wouldn't know how to receive it from somebody else. Somebody can say they love me, and I'd be like, okay. Now, that's mainly because I've never been in love myself, so. Is this someone that I'm interested in? Hell no. I've been single for the past how many centuries? So, no, there's no one on the horizon. There's no one in the view. There's no one right now. There's no one in my mind. And that's that. Done.